don't Max tax his upcoming budget could so easily make matters worse. The Chancellor is focused on jobs, and rightly so, but almost every day brings a new leak of a worrying Treasury plan to raise this tax. Our views on the madness of hammering working people with extra fuel duty are well known, but hiking corporation tax from the low levels which helped the Tories conjure a job creation miracle in the last recession is similar. Unemployment is at a five-year high. Once the furlough ends, the dole queue is likely to lengthen dramatically. Mr. Sunak must learn from history. In the decades after World War II, the US and West Germany encouraged the free market with lower taxes and far less state. Britain maintained high taxes and a big state controlling vast swathes of the economy. America prospered. West Germany rose from its ruins to become Europe's powerhouse. By the 1970s, Britain was Europe's basket case, begging a handout from the International Monetary Fund. In the post-COVID era, we could raise taxes, maintain the state at pandemic emergency levels, as labor would love, and entrench our decline for debt. Bonkers bills. Indeed, it is outrageous that the highest council taxes are across the red wall seats, formerly labor. It's no coincidence. Those seats turned blue in 2019. But the 10 worst-hit areas are still run by Labour councils, or weren't. And Labour's record on keeping local taxes low is dismal. Designing a new system is the start is surely to end the absurdity of basing bills on house prices. 30. A national revaluation is inevitable unless we are to use 1991's value. Class clowns. The welfare of kids or their parents is barely. The priority is always their members, and weaponizing them against the Tories. The NOI previously objected to reopening schools before child poverty is at. Its new excuse is it's simply too hard to get pupils back in a COVID testing regime in place before. Most teachers do a